then being able to do that with courage, so stepping it up that little bit, you know, how can we push ourselves out of our comfort zone a little bit further and being very clear, confident in that. Yeah, it's funny to reflect on this because, yeah, there's, you know, anything in life, there's a series of moments. But for me, it was in the aftermath of a burnout. So a corporate burnout, having suffered with, you know, mental ill health since I was a teenager. But coming out of that, I was looking around the corporate environment and seeing that I wasn't alone, that there was an increase in change and then a decline in mental health. And knowing my personal experience and all of my background in organizational change, it was like, we need to get better at adapting to change, and we need to do that in a way that doesn't sacrifice mental health. So my passion, my purpose, my life was born from there. Yeah, and it is very much that. It's how do we adapt to fast-paced change without sacrificing mental health? Yeah, I think it's a couple of things. Like my background for many, many years, so, you know, over 10 years is in organizational change, and that's where my, you know, ProSci accreditation, my coaching accreditation comes from. So that professional background that I have, but then the personal side that, you know, the wheels fell off. I lost my ability to perform and function in the workplace. It impacted my work, it impacted my family. And I see that I can speak to those two divides and how to find a path forward out of that. So I'm no stranger to being vulnerable, sharing. There's never any questions people can't ask me when I do a keynote or a workshop. And I think that's what's really appreciated, what's unique about how I help people, along with, lastly, it all comes together in my own change compass model, which is that's the tool that you use to navigate through change, and it's that sort of capability building within the organization that my focus is in. Help every individual be able to navigate through change with their own change compass, and that's the differentiator. Yeah, that. So for leaders, it is just equipping the individual. So much of change in organizations is, okay, there's a change, maybe it's a merger and acquisition. Okay, we're going to usher people through this change. Now we're going to roll out a new system. We'll bring people through that change. Then there's another change. So it's a series of change. And as a leadership team, we bring people through each one of those changes. The shift that I'm bringing about is getting people to think of, no, let's capability build people so they're able to adapt to any change. So it doesn't matter whether it's in the workplace or maybe it's outside of the workplace where they're going through a divorce. Maybe they're supporting someone through mental illness. Maybe they're supporting a family member who is ill. Any change that crosses their path, they then have the tools to be able to adapt to it. Yeah, I think there are three things. So one, there's a degree of empathy for what's going on with people around me. So not just about I'm steering the ship, I'm you know, leading this team or this organization, but how is everybody else going around me? The second thing I would say is courage, that you just have to have courage, that especially if you're going to be a leader who drives change, then you've got to be comfortable stepping outside of the norm. So being courageous and doing that to set people apart and to lead them forward. And then there's that vulnerability. And I know a lot is being said about vulnerability at the moment, but if you can share with your team some of the things that you're going through, how you respond to change yourself, then those things encourage others. It makes them feel like you're one of us. It just closes the gap between that top tier management and the front line, and just makes everyone feel like we're more human. So those leaders who do those well, so empathy, courage, and definitely showing vulnerability, they're the ones who are leading with heart and people are following them. Yeah. It's funny, I'm probably going to sound like a little bit of a fangirl here, and given that you're a New Zealander, but Jacinda Ardern, like I just see her at every moment raising the bar and really just stepping into who she is and setting a new playing field for everyone to say that this is what good leadership looks like. This is what people are responding to. This is what people are following with, without being, you know, beaten along with a stick or told you must do this, you must do that. It's really that encouraging people to come along the path. And yet she's done it in so many ways that, yeah, I find that I'm constantly smiling and just thinking, yeah, she is what great leadership looks like. Well, you're going to be able to tell that I have an 11-year-old daughter when you hear some of these. So, Pharrell, happy. It might seem crazy what I'm about to say. So, if I mentioned I suffer with mental illness, so when I'm down in the dumps, Happy is one of those songs. It's a mood shifter. I just think if I dance around the kitchen, dance around my office, hopefully with the camera off, those are the things that just, you know, kind of shift my energy state and just get me back in my sense of purpose. So Happy is my go-to song. The second one is I Will Get Back Up Again. Looking up at a sunny sky, so shiny and blue, and there's a butterfly. Well, isn't that a super fantastic sign? It's gonna be a fantastic day. Again, you can tell I do a lot of dancing around the house with my daughter, so that's another one. And the last one then is Miley Cyrus, The Climb. There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an up. Because I just feel that we're always trying to get better and better and better. And particularly with Speakers Institute Corporate, that's for us as a team, as a group, it's that constantly, you know, pushing each other to be better and then pulling each other along that journey. It's just, yeah, really great. So it's an old one. So Stephen Covey's The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. It is a book I go back to, and I wouldn't say that I've had memorized, but I use so many of the terms from that book. And yeah, every once in a while I go back and I reread it to just ground myself again. I just think there's such wisdom in it, and particularly, you know, what I think of things about sharpening the saw, that, you know, spirit of continuous learning, continuous development. And again, that's, you know, that's part of the environment of being at Speakers Institute Corporate, whether, you know, you're part of the team or whether you're one of the clients that, you know, that we have the privilege of working with. Okay, so this is, so I had a little bit of time to think about this, and for me, the word came to me at a silent retreat last year, actually year before last now, and the word is impermanence. So in the Buddhist tradition, embracing and opening up to that, everything changes. And like, as I said, my background is all about change. That's what I do in the world. So if I can help people embrace impermanence and just be ready for change at any point in time, then that serves you in so many ways as a professional and as a, you know, throughout your personal life. So impermanence, I just love the word, I love the concept, and I love the way of being in the world.